FYI. But when I was raised, I didn't grow up on, I didn't have an older brother or sister, so I just kind of listened to what my mother listened to, and there was church music, a lot of hymns, that kind of thing, so I've always had a fondness for that. Not the new kind, it kind of sounds like Coldplay, but it does. But the old kind, that sounds nothing like that. And then folk music and that kind of thing, and that's always kind of been where it starts for me. It's just, it's generally sitting like this without all the, and then other than that, it's just like that. So, when you sit down and write songs, it just kind of comes, like, you just sit with the guitar and you hope that you find something that works, because I found that if you can make songs work without anything else, then it works with everything else. And I think that anybody that writes songs will say that. So yeah, that's where it starts. And this is what I do. That, like, when it all is, no one's around, and the magazines aren't there, and managers aren't there, and no one's there, it's just me. It's just me and my wooden chair. Just hanging out with my, dead relatives in the grave. next to where Charles Dickinson wrote about stuff. No big deal. Just average Monday night. Did they serve you guys beer? They did. Wow. I'm going to pick up a song. I'm going to talk a song to you. So, how you doing? You alright? Yeah? Alright. You come to church a lot or no?
No.
Give it a shot once in your life. At least make up your mind later. Just try it once. See what happens. That's what I say to everybody. Just go and see for yourself. Maybe not now. Maybe when you're older, you see. Give it a shot. It's not always like this, though. Don't feel so bad. It's the best advice you can get when you're older.
Thank you.
hopes and nightmares probably won't kill me. And if I slow it down, I'll end up on my accuser's knives. But I won't stop the terror and love her at the red lights. I will take those never else give me. Stops nightmares probably won't kill me. If I slow it down, I'll end up on your knife. I always stop, I tell you that I love you at the red lights.
Said something real silly, like, you know, oh, well, you know, maybe just like, you know, people will take care of you and like love is all you need. Guy goes, love isn't gonna put a hole in my roof fixed, you know, like it's not gonna patch up that hole in the roof. I was like, I don't need any of that. He's like, I need money. Yeah. Yeah. Money fixes a lot of problems, not all of them, some of them. And then he goes, he said, money doesn't fix all the problems, but he goes, it fixes the ones I got. Yeah. I don't know if that's true. So this song is called Among Other Foolish Things.
Thank you. such foolish things like love, 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 love is all we need. And maybe it would be easy if we never ever had to bleed. Oh, and I'm taking a dive on a smoky set of eyes. I've been so deceived and I've been the one lied. And there was this one time when I painted a masterpiece.
I still like that quote so much. Money doesn't solve all the problems, but it solves the ones that I got. Good for him. Probably gave him a check. I like to watch TV for the silly parts. I like to watch the commercials and ignore the shows. I don't watch a lot of TV, but when I do, I like to watch the commercials and the bits on the news when they interview people. And I always find that they tell the truth sometimes because they're like, this is my 1 minute on television, so I'm going to say something that's going to be remembered forever. You know, you can always trust somebody who's only on television for 1 second. Because they're not going to lie to you. They got no time to lie to you. People who are on all the time, you got plenty of time to lie. So I like those people. This is what I was talking about. I'm trying to practice, so we'll see. We'll see if this comes off right. But when you do these kind of things, you know, I was trying to make it different a little bit for me and for you that would come and so you didn't just see me banging away on the same thing all the time. So we'll see. Maybe I'm growing up. I'm not sure. Hopefully. I figured as I get older, I should probably get better. So we'll see. I'm not sure, but we'll find out in about 3.5 minutes. I had to talk to those guys that come from, you know, places. You know, I can get into pretty much any car ever, like, quickly, and get it started and get it gone. Like, so if your car's out front, I can literally steal your car in less than 2 minutes. That's what I learned in New Jersey, which is useless, because I don't steal cars. So I've never stolen a car. Sometimes it's useful when you leave your keys in there and you're locking it, but now they got this thing where they can't lock them in. So what I didn't learn, which would have been more useful, was the thing of when guys used to play and girls used to play guitar, they used to accompany themselves a little bit. And then I think people have kind of gotten away in a little bit where you would kind of, I don't know if you care about this, but I'm going to tell you my name, this is my show. So what happened, and it's interesting to me, and I want to tell somebody, so you're here. What the thing is you got to keep the thumb and the other fingers doing separate things. It's like playing the drums. So you go like, your thumb's just going, you know, but it ends up going like, you know what I mean? Like, there's that. And it may sound silly to you, but to me, it's the difference between everything. It's like, that's like the gates to the, you know, key to the gates of everything. And so I had to go ask my friends, and I asked Corey Brandon, I was tweeting at Ryan Bingham and Jason Isbell, and they were going back and forth about how they learned how to do that, because those guys are like, those are pro guys. They know how to really play. They can play. And I was like, all right. I was like, time to grow up. Can't just put on a jean jacket, comb your hair funny, and think you're a singer or a songwriter or whatever. So I was like, you gotta really learn how to play. So it took some time, but like, I don't know. I was proud of myself for doing that for a month, and then getting here and being like, all right, cool. I thought I was gonna mess that up. So to me, that was a big deal. If it wasn't a big deal. Stopped in the middle, which is good. And anyway, so yeah, I'm pleased to be here today. I'm enjoying this. I like this. It's creepy and old. I don't hate that. I like creepy stuff. I like old creepy stuff. I like old creepy people. I like to keep them around me. I'm an old creepy person. So if you meet me outside of this, and it's not so funny, that's because I'm really a weirdo. Sorry. The song's not so weird. The meeting in real life, totally weird. Yeah, today's been a creepy day for me, because it's creepy, and I like being creepy, so I'm extra creepy today. I wish I was Batman. I don't know what that has to do with anything. They ask a lot about this song, always. So, and I never tell them the truth, because I just don't really like it. Because what's the point? Like, you just think of what you want to. But the reason is people go, why did you change that song? I said, because I had more to say in it. That's the truth. I had something else to say that wasn't quite wrapped around my head, and I wasn't done with it yet, and so I had to do it. And so, this is the first time I ever put out, like, a demo and completely changed the song. And I did it because I had more to say, so that's the truth. There you go. Built a room for you in the back of my mind with a ravenous wolf. Ghosts have no reason. You were amazing. You were always on my mind. We were secrets to keep. Crows buried side by side. But we tasted a kiss that was set from below. It was cool in the night. I was old as a stone. In the back of a car with a dry on your arm. Suddenly show you the teeth.
got you now, wrapped around my finger into the mystic. You were blue when I rages, and every night I would race the moon above you. Put you in for a drive that'll never be enough. Never gonna feel like when they first picked you up. When they drove you around, put you powder and flowers until the thrill was gone. But you said, I'm alright, baby, I don't mind. I'll get on just fine on them long rides. Last night, I remember being 17. I met a girl with a taste for the world and whiskey and rice and spring. Spent every night, except that she locked in a car that a bar would lock. And I could never get her to leave. She'd have said, I'm alright, baby, I don't mind. I'll get on. Drives without you. Nobody wins.
to those of you who are standing up but don't want to be standing up. I did learn an interesting fact about this place, that they just got indoor plumbing. So there's a restroom right outside if you need that. There's not a restroom back here, so if you need to go pee, too bad. But I do enjoy this place a lot. I think this is a nice kind of place, and I can see why people like playing here. So I don't know if you've been here before, any of you, but I have not, and it is very, very nice.
I'm so full from the bell. I waited many nights, don't wait anymore, she said. But what if I did? Did you think that I've been sleeping here alone, crying with no rain? See, I don't dig those kind of blues anymore, she says. But what if I did? Is that an invitation to use my love in your man's man's world? Maybe I'll be the one to roll you over, call when I wanna call you, honey, magnolia. I'll be the one to let you know when the sweetest is gone and it's over, honey, magnolia. Spent so many days just blowing it away, sleeping in the shirt that you wore. I used to race this town, crying at night, she says. I don't cry anymore. Maybe then I'll know to take you back in your man's man's world. Maybe I'll be the one to roll you over. Call when I wanna call you, honey, magnolia. I'll be the one to let you know when the sweet taste is gone. It's over, honey, magnolia.
Welcome company, I'm sure. Is that- definitely different though. Like you, with the whole thing, I find that people from areas are very proud of the area that they come from here, which I think is nice. We don't have that so much. Like people, some people are from New Jersey and some people from New York, but there's not really like a. It's all kind of blends together. There's not really like that big of a divide. Maybe it is between the Yankees and the Mets, but the Mets are awful, so. Yankees, come on. You guys even know about the New York Yankees, right? You might not know a thing about baseball, but you know the New York Yankees. You know why? Because God loves the Yankees. I'm telling you, Babe Ruth, all Derek Jeter. Yeah. You probably know who I'm talking about, too. Like a Gillette ad or maybe an Axe ad over here. Where you're spraying something on something. Yeah. The Yankees. Alright. Okay. This is either going to be cool or it's going to be the bane of my existence.
It's going to be cool.
Just awesome. Think about what you're doing. Second thoughts. Don't think twice, it's alright. that stuff. That's all the guys. They've been listening to me play it day in and day out for a month. Everywhere. At home, I've been playing it. Everybody's been like, all right, I'm ready with that thing. It took so long, so many hours. Like, that's not that cool. Yeah, well, you try it. You take the guitar and try to play that thing. That's hard. But, you know, anyway, it's one of those things. I'm trying, like I said, I'm trying to get better. You always try to get better, a little bit better every time. So that was one of those things that I studied. And I felt like when you study something, especially it's something that you already do, you feel like you go into complete toddler mode. Like, I've forgotten how to walk, and I've forgotten how to read. And you know, if you, the second you pick up Moby Dick, you realize you don't know how to read. And you have to get through it. It's really, really hard. And when you're kind of like stripped down to the most basic thing of what you already do, especially if you do it for a living, you have a moment of, well, maybe this is not my thing anymore. So it's really odd. And to push through, I think, is the key. But you can, if this old dog can learn new tricks, so can you. Got on the plane, allergies here. I never had to complain about stuff like allergies when I was 25. I could just be like, yeah, I got hit by a bus. I'm still at the show. What's going on, everybody? You know? And then now I'm like, well, I gotta drink water, and I gotta go to bed by 8:30, and the shows are earlier, and my knees hurt. It's gonna happen when I'm 40.
It gets worse.
Be called. This one's called painkillers. The next one would be called like omega-3. It's good for your joints, right? Fish oil or something like that. You don't have to worry about this forever. You just have like a little bit of orange juice. Don't smoke those nasty cigarettes. Don't ever do that. And maybe you can have a glass of beer. Don't freak out, but not now. Later on, you know, just don't be a mess. You know, you'll be fine. Your knees won't hurt. You'll be great. Your skin's great. Don't wreck that. You'll be good. This is someone's child I'm advising right now. I apologize. This is your child, I assume? Oh, just not yours. So he's fine. He's normal. Yeah. So I'm just telling you what he probably, your dad probably tells you, right? Yeah. About the omega-3, the fish oil, he's already on you about that? Because that would be foolish. I thought about daycare. I don't know if anyone can sign up online. We just give them a bunch of chocolates, mix some stuff together, and then we let them play in the street. Pickups at 5, though. This song's called Painkillers Daycare. Crowded room, and I catch myself like a spell falling onto you. I've been here before, just watching the wheels go round. Everybody that I've ever known, they just ache all night, and they wake up alone. Yeah, they wait in the dark for something to put us to sleep. Oh, my dear, you never know how haunts of the things you've done come and run you down. And you want love like it was a drug. All you wanted was a little relief from every heart I held in between. They were painkillers to me. They were painkillers to me. Could you be me love supreme? Cause we went down the slide just to hold on to anything. Most of the sparks of love, sweet little cherry bones. No, my dear, you never know how somebody burns you and spits you out. Then you won't love like it was.
Don't you love the way I drag you down? Ain't that enough for you now? Don't you want love like it was a drug? Yeah, don't you want a little relief from every heart I held in between? They were pain killers to me. They were pain killers to me. Want love like it was a drug. All we wanted was a little relief. And every heart I held in between. Well, they were pain killers to me. They were pain killers to me. Come get your pain killers for me. Thank you.
across himself. So thank you, Father, whoever it is that runs this place. I don't know what to say, but I'm out of practice. That's the thing, you know, I think choices like that laid out for me, I think choices give me anxiety, you know what I mean? You do, right? Yeah. Like pull and push on a door. So I says pull, but it's clearly not working, it's locked. What if I pull and it's really a push and someone's behind it and I break my hand? What if they break their hand? What if we both fall down? What if it's Dracula on the other end of the door? This is what happens in my mind, I don't know what happens to yours. Probably not that, you're all normal people. So when I was a kid, the big thing was diners. That's what we have. We have all night diners. Where you could go and you used to be able to smoke all the cigarettes you wanted, drink all the coffee you wanted, and stay at it all night long, and all the kinds of weirdos and creeps would come in. And so that's kind of how we used to be too. When we were younger, we would just sit there all night long, talk about who knows what. And I miss that a lot. And that's kind of what this song's about, then, those things. Because I don't think that has to be a young man's game. I think that could be anybody's game. So maybe once in a while, you stay up all night talking to somebody about nothing. And that's what this is about. Years ago now. And we were doing, we were in the middle of the handwritten record, and I went to a store to buy something, and there was this old guitar there, and I was like, oh, look at that one. You know, it's kind of beat up, and I was like, I like that one. And something was wrong with it, and I like guitars, but something wrong with them, because I have something wrong with it. So, yeah. I like those things. I find them endearing, you know. And then this one had been, you know, messed with a little and painted over, so it wasn't very valuable, but I said, that's for me. I like that one. I like the one that's not in pristine condition. The doctors or the lawyers can buy the other ones and not play them. And so what I did was I decided I'm going to get this guitar. And I brought it home, and I brought it to the place that we were staying at. Right, I was kind of sitting around just fiddling it. And this is the first time it's ever happened to me, but I sat down and just kind of literally went like this. Thank God I pushed record on the little dictaphone that I had with me though too. I never will forget you, my American love. Now always marry you wild as they come. And know if I saw you, I'd pretend not to know. Please where you were in my heart is now closed. I already live with too many goals. And everybody lately is living up in space. Flying through transmissions on invisible. Just waiting to be known. What's left for God to teach from his throne? And who will forgive us when he's gone? So take what you need now on here. Do what you like.
Thank you.
my record label for having the good idea of playing here. It was their idea. So thank you very, very much for that. And I do appreciate that. This was cool. So, yeah. Thanks for coming here. This was kind of fun. I think this was cool. Thank you, guys. This is very, very cool. I hope you had a good time. So I don't have time to stand out there today. I would if I could, but I don't. So if you stand out, we're both just gonna end up wet. And I gotta get inside. Later. I watched. I watched a lot of movies growing up. And I kind of thought that, I would be that guy in the movie. One of these days, watch Jimmy, from Wallace Avenue, watch. I don't care what your sister says about me. By the way, I kissed her in the back behind the barn when you were taking a shower. Sorry about that. But I'm going to be just like this guy in the movie. This was when I was poor. I was six. And a cap gun, and I was ready to fight for justice, freedom and stuff. Really just kind of maybe a little dessert after dinner, later bedtime. You know, the important things in the world, and I was ready with my cap gun. And I was like, I'm gonna get a car one day, take your sister, get out of here. That didn't happen. But in the end, I got the girl. Hey. Take my time. I can speak you up. I can pull you in. Take it enough. Let's go. Sliding in my veins. Cause this life is only chance. Nothing like the colors in my dreams. I just wanted to be Steve McQueen. My horse is of English racing green.
Racing green.
This life is always the same. Something like the colors in our dreams. We just want to be Steve McQueen in our horses of English racing green. You and me in British racing green. You and me in Steve McQueen.
Oh,